Hi guys, my name is Kamal Rawat and in this video we are going to discuss yet another interview problem related to linked list. So the question is as simple as adding two numbers. The only challenge is that the numbers are given in the form of linked list. So if the number is, let us say, 102, then the number is not given to you as integers, but the number is given to you as a linked list where each node of the linked list hold one digit of this number. So 102 means first node will hold 1, then next node has data value 0, and next node has data value 2. So 102, and we are given a pointer pointing to the head of this list. Let us say this is H1. Let us say another number which need to be added to this is 57. So this number obviously is given in the form of linked list where first node is 5 and second node is 7. And we are given a pointer to the head of this list. So this is H2. So we are supposed to add the two numbers given in the form of linked list. 102 plus 57 is 159. So answer should be a linked list representing 159. And we should return a pointer to the head of this list. So let us say this is result list. So this is our result. So our function should accept two node pointers. Let us say the name of my function is add. So this add function should accept two node pointers, node pointer H1 and node pointer H2. In case of Java, it will accept two node variables, node H1 and H2. Holding the references of first node of first and second linked list respectively. And this should return a node pointer that points to the first node of the result linked list. All right. So I think if the number is 10234 as given in this, and the second number is 124 as given in this, then the result should be 10234 plus 124, which is equal to 10358, given in the form of linked list. You should also take care of a condition where we have a carry overflow. So let us say the two numbers are 99 and 25. So in this case, the numbers are given in the form of 9 and 9 and 2 and 5. And the result of 99 and 25 is 124. So the result should be 124. So it is possible that the final linked list has more nodes than the linked list given in the input. All right. So with this problem statement, let us jump to the solution. Before getting into the actual solution, let us first see that the solution where we first change the linked list to a number. So let us say I change this linked list to an integer variable which hold 10,234, and I change the second linked list to a number which hold 124. Let us say this is in variable x, this is in variable y, then I perform x plus y and store it in, let us say, z. And then I convert Z to a linked list. So this solution may not work in all situations because this particular number may be a very large number which cannot be accommodated in any integer or long or double data type. So let us say if my number has 100 digits, then a 100 digit number cannot be accommodated in any data type in C or C++ or in Java. I understand that Python do not have any limit on number of digits in a numeric variable, but most other languages does. So we are not required to add the numbers as integers. We have to somehow add these numbers in the form of linked list only. Now the brute force way of thinking can be that let us first move to the last node, then add these last nodes. So let us first move to the last node. So this is my H1 and this is my H2, or we can have temporary variables because we want to preserve the head of first and second list. Then we add these two and the result is inserted in a new list, so 8. Then we move to the previous node, but we cannot go to the previous node in a singly linked list. So we have to again traverse starting from the first node. So this is not an efficient solution because it will be an on the order of n square time solution. A better solution maybe is to first reverse the first list, reverse both the list, and then add them. So if I reverse this number, if I reverse this linked list, then I will get 4, 3, 2, 0, 1. If I reverse the second number, then I will get 4, 4 followed by 2 followed by 1. Now H1 is pointing here and H2 is pointing here. Now probably what we can do is we can add the we just need to add H1 arrow data with H2 arrow data. So 4 plus 4 is 8, 8 will go here, then 3 plus 2 is 7, sorry, 3 plus 2 is 5, then 2 plus 1 is 3, 0 plus 0, because the second list is exhausted, so 0 plus 0 is 0, and 1 plus, so there is nothing in the second list, so it will be 1, right? So if there is a carry, let us say if this is 8 instead of 4, then 8 plus 4 is 12. So we will store 2 in the new list and 1 will go as a carry to the next digit, to the next node. All right. So initially the carry will be 0 and then we will add the data at H1 and H2. Then we will insert the data in the result list. Then we will move H1 forward and H2 forward. And we add H1 arrow data plus H2 arrow data plus the carry. So at any point of time, we are adding these three numbers. We are storing the units digit of this sum in some variable sum, and carry will be equal to the tens digit of this particular sum, and the final result list will hold the reverse of the number, reverse of the result. So we can just reverse the linked list, or maybe what we can do is that instead of adding at the tail of the list, we can add at the head of the list. So then 5 will be added at the head of the list. So it will be 5, 2, then 3 will be added at the head of the list. Sorry, it will be 6 because there is a carry also. So 6, 2, then 3, 3 is added at the head of the list. Then 0 is added at the head of the list and 1 is added at the head of the list. So this list becomes 1, 0, 3, 6, 2. So this will be the linked list. Now let us see the code. So this is the logic to reverse the linked list, and this is the main logic to add two numbers. We are given two linked lists pointed to by H1 and H2. First we reverse the two lists. So H1 is equal to reverse list H1, H2 is equal to reverse list H2. Then we take two variables, sum and carry, to represent the sum and carry of the individual sum. We also have a node pointer result list, which will hold the pointer to head of the result list, final list. Then we move in this while loop. So in this while loop, we will continue this while loop as long as there are nodes in either of the two lists. So either H1 is not equal to null or H2 is not equal to null. We will keep on moving this. So let's understand it with an example. Let us say my first number is 183. And let us say my second number is 992. So 992 and 183. The initial input is 183 and H1 is pointing here, and 992 and H2 is pointing here. So let's take these numbers. So first we will be reversing the list. So H1 will be 381 and H1 is here, and this will be 299 and H2 is pointing here. So we will be adding H1 arrow data. So in this case we have some variable. So initially the carry is 0 and sum is also 0. Then we add 3 plus 2 plus 0. So sum will be equal to 5. Sum will be equal to 5. So sum will H1 arrow data and H2 arrow data will be added to sum, and H1 is now pointing to this. H2 will now point to this. Then carry is equal to sum divided by 10. So carry will remain 0. So we create a new list. We create a new node with the value 5. We are creating a new node here. Then again we move to the start of the loop. H1 is not equal to null and H2 is also not equal to null. So we perform 8 plus 9. 8 plus 9 is 17. So sum is equal to 17. Then sum is equal to sum divided by 2, which means carry is equal to sum divided by 10, which means carry is 1 and sum is 7. So this 17, out of this 17, 1 will go in the carry part and 7 will go in the sum part. And then we create a new node with the value sum and we insert that node at the head of the list. So this is my result list. All right. Now carry is 1. Again, H1 is moved forward. So H1 is pointing here and H2 is also moved forward. So H2 is pointing here. Now H1 and H2 are not null. So we add H1 arrow data, H2 arrow data and carry. So it will be 1 plus 9 plus 1, that is equal to 11. So out of this 11, 1 will go in the carry part and 1 will go in the sum part. So a node will be created with the sum value, which is 1, and carry will be equal to 1. H1 and H2 are moved forward. So now H1 is equal to null and H2 is equal to null because both the linked lists are now exhausted. So this will bring the execution control outside the while loop. So since we have moved outside the while loop, we are checking that if carry is not equal to 0, which in this case is not, so it will create a new node with the carry. So 1 1, and this is the result. This is the final result and this will be returned. So 183 plus 992 is equal to 1175. This is the answer. All right. You can download the code from the link given in the description below. And for more such videos, please like and subscribe our channel. Thank you.